Alright, so we got some rhymes. But that's not what this video is about. Video is not about wet sand. This video is not about trash and paint. This video is about the history of this car. Now, if everybody don't know, you just come in checking out the videos. I want you to understand that this car isn't a junkyard car. This car isn't a car that I bought off the streets. This car is not a car that I put a lick on and chopped it up. This car was handed down from Pops. Alright. And Pops, passed just a few years back. And when he passed, and still been tough dealing with the unexpected past, you know, the Pops is hell. As I progress in age, I realized was still much very young. I mean, he never even made it out of his 50s. Matter of fact, didn't even hit his early 50s. Now, getting back to the history of this car. When Pops bought this car, he bought the car off the showroom floor in 74. He had a good time with it. Just like everybody do with a brand new car. But I suspect that when he got his K5 4x4 85 Chevy Blazer, that he had a new toy. And the Cutlass sat for years under rain, under Georgia heat, under snow. And a few years back, especially in my neighborhood where I grew up in, I said, well, you know what? If I don't bring this car over to my house, because at the time, you know, not at the time, but, you know, we'd have a garage growing up. And, neighborhood wasn't the safest, if you understand what I'm saying. So, I went ahead and had the car towed to my house. Because I felt like in a little bit, especially since I don't know the same people that did that type of business back then. You know, we got the little ones these days, and they ruthless. No respect. I say, you know what? This car be gone if I don't look up and take it. So I took it and I started working on it. And it wasn't until I started doing the videos where you saw, I said, let me start doing this body work because I want this to be done by the time I have Lil C. So, getting back to Pops, I'm going flip flop and just bear with me. This car was actually a nemesis to me. I mean, I actually had a serious issue with this car. And the reason why I had a serious issue with this car, because, you know, when Pops used to pick me up from, you know, school, wherever I was in the late day, I mean, I even remember, you know, having an issue with the time, you know, TV shows came on. Like prime example, Webster. You know, it used to come on, I believe, at 6 or something here in the A. And I just remember, you know, being nervous every time the show came on, because that means that I was getting picked up late. And when I was getting picked up late, it was going to be Pops. And I did something wrong, and I was about to get an ass whipped. So with that said, let me tell you how bad this is. A few years back, maybe a couple years back or whatnot, I was at the pool hall. We shot, matter of fact, me and my old lady, we shot a pool with Chris Tucker and Emmanuel Lewis. Emmanuel Lewis is a dude that played Webster. And I even told him while we were shooting, I said, dude, I got an issue, you know, with you, even though you're cool. I got an issue with you that I'm even getting nervous, you know, more so around you, not because of your status, because I'm not that type of dude, I'm not a bopper, but more so because it's making me nervous because of the show that you used to play on, the Webster show. So anyway, you know, he was like, oh, okay, whatever, dude, whatever. I don't even know what you talk about. But, you know, after a few drinks or whatever, we was kicking it. I realized that, you know, there's certain things more so like even this car that, you know, I hold on to, you know, or if I had these different experiences that really makes me feel a certain type of way, more so emotional. And just bear with me so you understand where I'm coming from. So when it came down to this car, because with Pops, like I said, Pops was a disciplinary, and don't get me wrong, you know, he showed me a lot of love, and I appreciate that and love that to this day, because a lot of fathers are not even in their sons' lives, in their daughters' lives, you know. So, you know, I've been truly blessed to have him. So don't get that confused that he's a disciplinary, that he's been showing me love. But you know, and again, the provider of the family. But with that said, when it came down to doing this car, and even now, I didn't get more so nervous about it coming out bad. More so of then, I wanted to make sure that he was happy with it, you know? Yeah, I'm secondary in this, you know? Because to me, I feel like this car still is. And that's why I'm trying to make this thing as of and to perfection. You know, so conceptually, you know, I work with, let's say not even conceptually, but practically, the car is in my name, you know, registered and all that good stuff. But at the same time, conceptually, it's still his. So when I'm working on it, and he's working on it with me, you know, in spirit, you know, I really want to make sure it's done right. So that's why you see me taking my time. That's why, I it might have been spit on, you know, a couple days ago. About to go a couple days on. But at the same time, I want to make sure I take my time, get everything out, do the best job I can. And that's what I'm doing. So the next video you should see, it should be done. Stay with me.